Great Scott.
Great Scott.
Great Scott.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Great Scott. I'm Scotty V. Thanks for watching. Today I want to talk about the Edge. What I mean by this is that a few days ago, I guess Dylan Sprayberry came out in an interview. He's playing young Clark Kent in the upcoming Man of Steel film, and he used the words edgy. And this has been sprung about all over the internet. People have been complaining about darkness and edginess and realism and why can't it be a fantasy and it's Superman and it needs to be bright and cheery. It needs to be square. He should be like Captain America. He should be geeky, but he should be patriotic and he should do all the right things and say all the right things. I want to try and calm everybody down if I can. I think that edgy simply means... Yes, possibly the world will be a little darker, maybe a little more realistic. The villains will be a little easier to swallow, and they won't be as laughable as Lex Luthor, Otis, other characters have been during other times, even in the Superman Returns movie, where I thought Lex Luthor was much closer to a evil, serious, maniacal baddie that you could actually take seriously. They still had that campiness that Gene Hackman brought to the role in the Donner films. And I know that everybody goes on and on about how they love the Donner films, how they set a benchmark for superheroes, and they may very well have back in the 70s when a superhero movie or television show was never taken seriously. And from that perspective, those movies were the first time that the George Reeves series was pretty serious. But it was the first time that maybe adults could look at a superhero and say, this can be an adult movie, this can be a realistic movie, this can be a movie that I can take the whole family to, but at the same time, be serious about. And I think that's what people mean when they talk about the Donner films. Now, for me, I have always felt that they held a bit too much camp, a bit too much comedy, a bit too much silliness, and it seemed to me that they didn't really take themselves incredibly seriously. It was kind of a goof. There was a lot of goodness from the moment on Krypton up until he gets to Metropolis that was taken very seriously and done in a way that would be honorable very well even today. But with Man of Steel and with Nolan on board and with Snyder directing, I think it's clear from the beginning that we're going to see a slightly different version of the Superman film that we have seen before. No one can expect that with Nolan involved that there's going to be a heck of a lot of camp. My problem with Nolan and the idea that Nolan isn't really a fan of the over-the-top mythos of the comic books, even in Batman's case, is that he has said many, many times that he's unwilling to bring people like the Penguin, the Riddler, Killer Croc, things of this nature, into his movies because they don't fit in his world. Well, I know that this is his version in the movies, but his world is Batman's world. It doesn't really belong to him, and it's a story about a guy who runs around in a bat suit and fights crime. So it bothers me sometimes when he seems to poo-poo the other aspects of the comic, but at the same time doing a comic book film. So I've always been concerned from the beginning that Nolan was involved, and I'm one of the, maybe the only one on earth that did not enjoy the new Batman films particularly. I thought Batman Begins had much more characterization, much more depth of character and character dilemma and emotion in it, and that The Dark Knight was not much more than a spectacle movie where Batman does one cool thing after another and we're forced to watch. Now, again, most of the world didn't feel forced at all, and it's one of the most successful films of all time, not just one of the most successful superhero films of all time. So, of course, the powers that be at Warner Brothers are going to want to try and recapture that, only with a different superhero. And obviously, we all hope that they don't lose sight of what Superman is about, and that he's the hope that brings light to the world and is a beacon of greatness, even in the midst of great darkness. Now, I personally have been an advocate for many years that Superman TV shows, Superman animated projects need to have some darkness in them that comes from the bad guy, from the villain, that comes from the world outside of Superman and his characters that he interacts with on a regular basis, but that Superman is always that hope shining in the darkness, that by the end of a series or whatever it is, he triumphs. And through all that, we see the positivity of the character, the uplifting morality of the character, and the inspirational qualities that Superman should always have. Now, obviously, we can't know until the movie comes out, but I have hope that Snyder and company are going to bring that, and that we have a good opportunity to see something like that. So let's not get too upset and too afraid of the word edgy. Yes, it can be taken over the top, but I think if we see a real world type setting, even with fantasy characters in it, it's a much more acceptable film these days. And I think that Donner got some of that done by showing us New York that was called Metropolis, and by having real people, and by having Superman have some issues with real dilemmas. But when Lex Luthor got involved and things got a little over the top, that's when it lost its way. And I don't necessarily expect something like that from Nolan and Snyder and everybody else that's involved. So I think that we're going to see an impressive action spectacle, but at the same time have the opportunity to possibly see emotional complexities from not only the hero, as many people are already saying, many versions of Superman have already shown that he has complex emotional issues and then that he deals with regular humanity on a regular basis, but also from the villain side, that hopefully we see some emotional explanation, some depth, some character development, which in my mind The Dark Knight did not accomplish nearly as well as Batman Begins, and even that I personally was disappointed with those. They are quality films, and if this Superman film is held to that same quality, but for my money has a better story, a better depth of character, and really delves into these guys, I think we're going to see something great. Remember, everybody, always look up in the sky.